ISIS is on the march in Iraq and Syria, taking over key cities and killing its opponents. But despite the radical Islamic group's victories, the White House refuses to admit its strategy to stop ISIS isn't working. Dale Hurd has the story.
With the fall of the ancient city of Palmyra and a nearby military base, ISIS now controls half of Syria. There are fears ISIS soldiers will destroy the city's priceless artifacts, as they've done in other cities, because they view the historic treasures as sinful idols. This after ISIS fighters seized the city of Ramadi in Iraq over the weekend. Critics are again saying the White House strategy against ISIS is not working. The administration says it is, and no formal strategy review is planned. President Obama doesn't think America is losing, and told The Atlantic magazine the fall of Ramadi is just a tactical setback. Defense experts disagree, telling lawmakers on Capitol Hill Thursday that the U.S. strategy is failing, and that's why the U.S. is losing to ISIS.
Looking at this strategy today, we know now that the conceptual plan is fundamentally flawed. We are, in fact, losing this war. Moreover, I can say with certainty that this strategy will not defeat ISIS.
ISIS is not losing. I believe that the U.S. has continued to underestimate the Islamic State, which I suspect shows a lack of understanding about the Islamic State, its capabilities, strengths, and weaknesses, and how it sees the fight and a path to victory.
The administration would like the world to forget that President Obama once belittled ISIS as just the JV team, the junior varsity. It's far from that.
This is a group of unfathomable evil, and unfortunately, they are extremely effective. This is a serious threat. What I can't discern is any coherent American strategy to respond to this threat.
It's abundantly clear that ISIS knows what it's doing. And critics warn it's less clear that the White House does. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Whatever your political leanings, can I suggest that you pray for our country in more than just a brief prayer? Pray for our leaders. Whether you're in line with them or not, we need to ask for God's wisdom to resonate in the things that they do. We really, really all need to petition heaven at this time for the direction our country's going in and for the rest of the world. Well, speaking of the rest, for the rest of today's top stories, let's go to John Jessup at our CBN News Bureau in Washington. John?
Thanks, Terry. The slaughter, persecution, and forced migration of Christians and other religious minorities in the Middle East is an issue bringing Republicans and Democrats on Capitol Hill together. More than 70 House lawmakers across the political and religious spectrum are working to reauthorize an amendment that would protect religious minority groups in Iran. The Lautenberg Amendment would allow at-risk groups like Iran's Christians, Baha'is, and Jews to apply for asylum here in the U.S. Illinois Republican Congressman Randy Hultgren told CBN News that America needs to be a safe haven for religious freedom.
So many of our founders came here because they wanted religious freedom. They didn't want a state church. They didn't want to be forced to practice a certain type of religion or a certain denomination. They wanted to come here to be free in all areas of life.
Hultgren also said persecution is on the rise in Iran, and with the instability in Iraq and other areas, religious minorities have fewer places to flee. Josh Duggar, the oldest child from the TLC series 19 Kids and Counting, has confirmed allegations of molesting underage girls more than a decade ago when he was a teenager. In Touch magazine reported that the 27-year-old Duggar was investigated in 2006 for alleged misconduct. On Facebook, he posted, 12 years ago as a young teen, I acted inexcusably, for which I am extremely sorry and deeply regret. I confess this to my parents, who took several steps to help me address the situation. Duggar added that he and his parents spoke with the authorities and that his parents arranged for counseling for him and those affected by his actions. His parents and his wife are standing by him. Jim Bob and Michelle Duggar said, that dark and difficult time caused us to seek God like never before. You can read the rest of the Duggar statements and keep up with more of the story by going to cbnnews.com. Josh has also resigned his position as executive director of the Family Research Council's lobbying arm, FRC Action. This land is ours, that clear message delivered by Israel's new foreign deputy minister. And she says Israel owes no apologies for its policies in the Holy Land God gave to the Jewish people. Zippy Hotaveli made those remarks in a speech to Israeli diplomats Thursday. Hotevelli is an Orthodox Jew, and she referenced the Bible several times in her speech. At just 36, she represents the younger generation in Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's Likud party, who support new settlements in the West Bank, and she opposes surrendering it to the Palestinians.
We expect, as a matter of principle, that the international community recognize Israel's right to build homes for Jews in their homeland everywhere.
Hotevelli is currently the country's top full-time diplomat. Well, thousands of Christians from all over the world came to Jerusalem to celebrate the biblical holiday of Pentecost in the city of Pentecost. It's part of a movement called Empowered 21. They want a fresh touch 2,000 years after the early church first received the gift of the Holy Spirit. Chris Mitchell brings us that story from Jerusalem.
They came to worship, pray, and celebrate Pentecost 2015.
Organizers of Empowered 21 believe the gathering represents the largest meeting of believers in Jesus to celebrate Pentecost since the first one nearly 2,000 years ago.
They represented every continent.
We're all from Burkina Faso, West Africa, and being here for this conference is very, very meaningful because we are in the Holy Land.
What does it mean for you to be here?
I want to experience Holy Spirit.
We came with Spirit Life Church from Arizona and The Rock from Anaheim and from Katy, Texas.
Life Church!
Life Church from Katy, Texas.
Empire 21 is a relational network. This is a key word. We are relating together in the Spirit-filled, Spirit-empowered movement around the world. So this is the bringing together of Pentecostals and Charismatics across denominational lines to talk about unity, the power of the Holy Spirit, and how we help new generations connect with God.
The Pentecostal Charismatic movement around the world is growing dynamically. It's the growing edge of Christianity. It's been estimated by various scholars that the Spirit-empowered movement embraces somewhere between 600 to 700 million believers.
Speakers came from around the world, including CBN CEO Gordon Robertson.
One of the things that I wanted to accomplish here was to present Superbook, and to present Superbook to a global Christian audience, to let them know that they can get the stories of the Bible in their language, for their country, for their children.
Superbook reached more than 100 million children last year. It's one side of what some say is the greatest harvest in the history of the church.
At the same time, there is a global outpouring of the Holy Spirit with signs and wonders. And this conference is all testimony to that. We're hearing speakers from nation after nation talking about the great miracles God is doing in their country.
And organizers expect the best is yet to come.
Our goal in the Spirit-empowered movement in Empowered 21 is to see that by the year 2033, which will be the 2000th anniversary since Jesus ascended into heaven, that every person on the planet Earth will have an opportunity to respond to the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Looks like a great time. Terry, your ladder will be greater. The best is yet to come.
I'm going to amen that, brother. I just want to say there's something incredibly inspiring about being in Israel to celebrate any biblical feast. But how wonderful to see so many believers from all over the world coming together, asking God for more of Him, more of His presence, more of His power. It's awesome.